My baby, you know it. Top everything, everything, you know it. King already, already, you know it. Shine already, shine already, shine already, shine already, shine
already, shine already. Hey, light already, hey, light already, shine already, shine already. Wait, okay. The old school B. Scott, how are you guys doing today? I am Honest Am, the writer and creator of the Honesty Sis newsletter, a bi-weekly newsletter geared towards millennials who are truly trying to get their shit together. And I am here for another daily motivational video. You know, like, come on, you guys. Where's the fucking energy? Thank God. All right, y'all. Let's go ahead and get right into it a little bit about me. I do not just use the tarot. I use God and cusses in the same sentence. But if it does not stop Charlemagne the God, it ain't gonna stop me. All right, y'all. Angel number 57. Make sure you check out the description box below. There are always additional information, angel messages, as well as information about me at honestlysis.com. If you're interested in donating or connecting with me in any way, all of that information is down below. All right, 115. So, God, what messages do you have for us to become the alchemists of our lives, to help bring heaven on earth, or just to do magic in public? God, what is one thing that we really need to know in order to be the alchemists of our life? What is one concept that we just need to have ingrained in our heart? What mantra do we need to wake up with on our lips every morning in order to become the alchemists of our life, God? If any of our guardian angels, ancestors, or beings of light would like to come in, know that they are more than welcome. Beings are light only. God, I'm asking you just give me one mantra or affirmation that we need to know and to take to heart in order to become the alchemist of our lives. Just one, please. Make it as plain as possible. Last shuffle. Alright. So ours is going to be the bottom card. And God is saying, I am healthy. I honor my body and I'm grateful for the work it does for me. I nourish my body through self-care. I rest when I need to rest. I eat nourishing meals when I need to eat. And I exercise when I am healthy, I honor my body and I am grateful for the work it does for me. I nourish my body through self-care. I rest when I need to rest. I eat nourishing meals when I need to eat. And I exercise when I need to. I am healthy. Angel number 242. So God, he says that in order, the mantra that you need to have in your mind in order to become the alchemist of your life is that I am healthy. And this mantra, this affirmation, card 17, which goes down to 8, which talks all about abundance and all that good stuff, abundance and wealth. I feel like what God is saying is that you have been doing a lot of the mental work. You have been, you know, changing your mindset. You have been working on how to speak differently with yourself. And now I feel like God is saying, now it's time to work on a body. That's personally something that I have been focusing on. And, you know, and I don't say it in a way of where people are like, oh, you can't eat red meat, you can't do that. But it's just like what this card is saying. Learning how to honor your body, learning how to listen to your body when it's saying, I need to rest, or learning how to listen to your body when it even says it wants certain meals. Like, I woke up this morning and it was like, I definitely needed to get a green smoothie in me. And that's just because I'm listening to my body. I know that I actually have been changing my diet. It's just naturally my diet has been changing to more of a Mediterranean diet, which actually makes sense because a Mediterranean diet is very focused on the heart. And if you pay attention to me in the channel, in these videos, I told you guys I've been going through a lot of heartbreak and just, you know, a lot of endings. And it feels like not only is this diet going to help my body, but also heal me inside. And so I say that to say that, you know, I'm a big girl, you know, and I know that hearing, you know, having restrictions on your food or somebody telling you what you can't do, like for me, that's going to automatically make me want to do it. You know, like that's going to automatically shut me down. But if you really just look at it in terms of recognizing that your body is a vehicle, and if you think about your body as a vehicle that houses your soul, think about if you have a car and like you just never, you don't put the right gas in it, you don't get no oil changes. You just running this car up and down the road. Like, eventually your car is going to break down. And that's the same thing with your body. If you are always feeding junk and garbage in your body, and that's just not talking about fast food and fried food, but that's just like, if you're just, it can also mean the type of music you're listening to, the type of movies that you're watching, like all of that is our diet. And so I feel like what God is saying, if you found yourself like say there was a period of time where I was highly sensitive to violent movie shows. Like, I just could not watch it. Like, it was just too much for me. And instead of just being like pushing myself and, you know, trying to watch it anyway, or being like, you know, what's wrong with me? I just respected that. And now I'm like back on this place where I can watch that type of television. I just feel like God is just really trying to get the message across that you have to become one with your body. Like, there is no ascending without you, again, becoming into full alignment, and your body is included in that alignment. And I feel like what God is saying is just, now is the time for you to really, really pay attention to your, you know, your body, your health, the things that you're feeding yourself. You know, are you resting? Are you taking care of yourself? Like, that's just a really big thing. And I feel like it's so important, because a lot of us, when we are on this mission to better ourselves, we are just so focused on, you know, making sure our mindset is right, having a passion. And sometimes we just forget about that body part. And it really is a trifecta. In order to get ourselves in alignment, we do have to make sure that we're honoring our body and we're putting those proper things in our body. And I don't feel like it's for you to, you know, be super strict and try to become a bodybuilder, or for you to only eat vegetables every day. Like, I just don't even feel like that is... that's also can become an obsession, you know, like trying to make sure you stay under another thing. I don't even think that's what God is trying to get there. Like, I truly feel like God is just saying, listen to your body. Your body will naturally just gravitate towards where you need to go. Just like I was telling you, I've been gravitating. My body was like, I've always thought about doing yoga, not realizing that it's my body saying, hey, I want to do yoga. Yoga will help me become in the best optimal shape. And it wasn't until I actually just listened to it and override, you know, my mindset, I realized like, oh, wow, like this, I really fuck with yoga. You know, like it really makes me feel good. And then that just opened me up to so many other things. So if there has been just, you know, ideas coming up for, you know, different exercise regimens or different sleep habits, you know, like maybe you're thinking about different ways to improve your sleep habits or just anything to take care of yourself, to nourish yourself, really pay attention to that, because that is how you become the alchemist of your life. Angel number 733. The last card that God is wanting us to just focus on is saying that I am alive. I honor my life by letting go, dancing, singing, and feeling the fullness of joyful energy. I am my true self when I am having fun and I am alive. And so I feel like this message is really, to me, again, that message of honoring your body. Like, I feel like for some of you guys, your body has been wanting to just have fun. It's been wanting to laugh more. And I feel like, you know, maybe you may feel like it's silly that you know, you've been listening to music or you've been having these little dance concerts, these dance parties, but listen to your body, because obviously your body is saying that's what you need. And also just dancing around your living room, like twerking, whatever the fuck you want to do, that is a form of exercise. And that's also a form of changing your energy up. So again, your body could be saying it wants to exercise because it's trying to release some shit from your body. What we have to realize is that everything is energy, right? So even when we have an emotional experience, if we have an emotional experience, that gets stored down in our body, right? And if we never address it, it just get, you know, just get clogged up in there and just more stuff going there. And if we never look at it, that's when those type of things can manifest into like a physical ailment, like cancer and all that type of shit, right? And so when your body is saying, I want to move, or when you're listening to a song and you feel like you want to cry, cry, because your body is trying to release, because obviously the song is triggering a memory and these tears are coming to cleanse you and to block that energy out. If you've been feeling shitty, like go dance, go sing, you will shake your energy out. That's why you feel better, because you're shaking your energy out. Like, I can't stress that enough, to become one with your mind and your body. Angel number 934. God, where are we going from here? Okay, I'm going to just get one tarot card to just see. God, clarify this message of I am healthy and I am alive. What are you trying to get us to understand about becoming one with our body so we can become the alchemists of our life? What are you trying to get us aware of? This card of I am aware. When I pay attention to my surroundings, I can feel appreciation for everything. So, God, what are you trying to get us to understand about being healthy and about feeling alive and about becoming one with our body? God, clarify this message and make it as plain as possible. So you're feeling trapped, angel number 1028. Your underlying energy is that you are feeling trapped, as though, you know, this is as good as life is going to get for you. This is pretty usually going to be, you know, this is the most, I don't know. You're just feeling trapped. I can't even begin to understand why you feel this way. But the thing that I want you to understand is that these are all self-imposed things. You are trapped because of the words that you say to yourself. You're trapped because you, instead of exploring your emotions, you decide to just hold them in. You decide to cage them off. You don't really see the truth of your situation. And because you can't see the truth of your situation, that's why you feel so trapped. And so I feel like with this message, with the Empress coming out with I am healthy, angel number 1111, your thoughts, what God is saying is your body is trying to get you into this new cycle and trying to get you to feel more abundant and feel more alive. But in order for you to feel more alive, in order for you to feel more abundant, you have to let go of these self-imposed limitations. The things that you say, oh, I'm gonna always be this way, or I can't. Nobody's telling you have to go on a keto diet. Just listen to what your body is saying. If you eat a bag of hot Cheetos and your stomach is fucked up afterwards, or the morning after, your body is saying, hey, we can't take that no more. I love Chipotle, vinaigrette dressing. I can't eat it no more. I will wake up one morning, my stomach would just be all messed up. And it's like, instead of just, you know, trying to fight against that, I'm honoring our body. And so God is saying, when you honor your body, when you rest when you need to rest, or when you dance when you need to dance, when you take care of yourself, when you become one and you really start looking at your body like a temple, then you'll be able to birth and to birth those new ideas and those creations, because you will be able to recognize the power within yourself. You'll feel more pretty because you're taking care of yourself. I feel like you don't take care of yourself because you're like, oh, nobody's gonna love me. Nobody's gonna do this. Da, 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 da. I'm gonna be like this. And it's like, you don't even try. You haven't even tried. Give yourself a chance. God is saying, I feel alive. I honor my life by letting go. We have the Four of Swords come out. A lot of stuff with swords. Swords deal all about communication, the way that we communicate with ourselves and others. And again, she's laying in this bed and it's like she got a headache. Like, she's just so depressed. And I feel like that's you. Like, you're just like, you feeling trapped. You feeling like, you know, like, oh my God. Like, you wake up every morning like, why is this my life? And I feel like God is saying, in order to, like, to even stop feeling that way, you got to change your body. Like, you have to move your body. Like, I honestly feel like that's what it is. Like, God is saying, you're feeling trapped. You're feeling so depressed because you're not moving your body. You need to move your body. You need to take care of yourself, and you need to eat better. Because I feel like, because you're feeling depressed, you're eating shitty food, you're watching shitty shit, and it's just like shitty, shitty, shitty. You need to change it up. And if not even, you don't have to do this for a long period of time. Do it for a couple of weeks or so. But I think that'll make you feel better. Like, I just feel like you don't feel very well. You feel very trapped. And I feel like what God is saying, once you start moving your body and, like, really listening to your body, really listening to the promptings that are coming up in your life, you'll start feeling more alive. You won't feel so depressed. You'll feel like you have something to look forward to, because the sun is coming out. The sun and the Ace of Swords. So it's like, positivity is there. Like, I mean, even with this energy with the Empress and I am healthy, it's like, God is saying you have it. It's just the way that you're looking at it and the way that you're communicating with yourself, or rather not looking at your situation, that's why you feel so shitty, because you're not looking at the truth of your situation. So a good example of that is, like I was saying, like, you know, just, you know, your body. I don't know, like, you eating, just, I don't know. I'm done. You eating bad, not doing that, that just, it'll help you not really feeling well. Yeah. That's all I got for y'all. Angel number 15. I really don't have anything more. I'm going to read. I'm actually going to get our your final word from Jesus is calling, enjoying peace in his presence. Hopefully this clarifies this message. Keep your eyes on me, not only for direction, but also for empowerment. I never lead you to do something without equipping you for the task. That is why it is so important to seek my will in everything you do. There are many burnt out Christians who think more is always better, who deem it is unspiritual to say no. In order to know my will, you must spend time with me, enjoying my presence. This is not a onerous task, but a delightful privilege. I will show you the path of life in my presence and in fullness of joy. At my right hand, there are pleasures. At my right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Also, I'm going to read this one too, because it just kept calling out to me. Angel number 16:16. Rest in the stillness of my presence while I prepare for you this day. Let the radiance of my glory shine upon you as you wait on me in confident trust. Be still and know that I am God. There is both a passive and active side to trusting me. As you rest in my presence, focusing on me, I quietly build bonds of trust between us. When you respond to the circumstances of your life with affirmations of trust, you actively participate in this process. I am always with you, so you have no reason to be afraid. Your fear often manifests itself in excessive planning. Your mind is so consumed to this pattern of thinking that you are only, your mind is so accustomed to this pattern of thinking that you are only now becoming aware of how persuasive it is and how much it hinders your intimacy with me. Repent of this tendency and resist it. Whenever you realize you are wandering down this well-worn path, return to my presence, which always awaits you in the present moment. I accept you with no condition. Angel number 7330. And so I read those two messages to you because I feel like what God is saying is that keep your eyes on the prize. Keep your eyes on him. Know that as long as you are focused and you are deciding that you're going to be the best person that you can be, that you're going to walk into the light, that you are going to approach every day as the Empress, and knowing that you are healthy, knowing that you are worthy, honoring yourself and your body, then there's no need for you to worry. There's no need for you to feel trapped. There's no need for you to feel like, you know, everything is against me. Change the way that you think and you speak about yourself. Learn to honor your body and you will change your life. All right, y'all, that's all the messages I have for you. I really hope it was beneficial for you. It was kind of a weird message for me, but I hope that it was a blessing to you. I'm going to leave you with this. God, what blessing is imparted on our lives? For my viewers, leave no room for confusion. Please give us clarity with this message, God. What happens if we take on the mindset that we are healthy and we are glad to be alive? What if we decide to walk into our light, knowing that we are the Empress of our life and removing all self-imposed limitation? What if we decide to see the truth of our life and to become aware of how we hold ourselves back? What blessing will you impart in our life? God, make it as plain as possible. One card only, please. I said one card only. I'm just going to take this one. Be grateful for all of your experiences. For all in life serves a purpose. There is a blessing in that did or didn't happen. There is a blessing unfolding this very moment. Listen to your heart and follow its wisdom. Be mindful, for the journey is as important as the destination. And so I leave you guys today. If you feel like you are trapped, if you've been staying up at night worrying and planning, I ask that you just let that worrying go. I ask that you just focus on the life that you are creating. Focus on being present and being in your body. Get out, go laugh, go play, go have fun, and then watch God bring it all about. All right, y'all, that's all the messages I have for you. I truly hope it was beneficial for you. If you made it to the end of this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you really love it, make sure you subscribe so you will never miss out. Until we meet again, dream those dreams. Never let the internet rush you, and never, ever let someone tell you what you cannot do. Namaste. Angel number 2010. Take care. Bye.